Hello everyone, in this video tutorial, we are going to discuss how to write the script for creating data fitting neural network in MATLAB. In the last video, we have discussed the graphic user interface for the same. So I've already written the code. In this video, we will be discussing this code line by line. So what we basically will be doing is like creating a random function and then providing it with the inputs and then obtaining the output from it. Then we will provide some test data to this created function as well as our trained network and then compare those two results obtained to check the accuracy of the network. So let's begin with it. These are the standard commands. So I've created x1, x2 and x3 as inputs by providing any random by using random integer with maximum value of 100 and 100 inputs I am providing. Then combining these into a single array. This is the function I am talking about. So in this I will be providing x1, x2 and x3 as the input and y will be the output. So this is the function I was talking about. This is just a random function. So this will contain 100 values. This command gives the training function of train VR. This gives the number of hidden neurons as 10. This is fitnet, is the standard inbuilt MATLAB command for data fitting neural network. So we provide it with the number of hidden neurons and the training function. This line shows that the processing we have to do for the inputs we have supplied. This has the MATLAB inbuilt processing functions, remove constant row and map min max. Remove constant row removes the constant rows that we may be supplying as it reduces the accuracy of the network. Map min max is just for creating the inputs we have in a particular range. Divide function, we are using divide random for randomly dividing the data set we have available. Divide mode is sample. This line shows the ratio in which we divide the data in the training, validation and test. The number of epochs or the iteration are specified by this. The performance function is mean square error I have used like this. Train is the MATLAB command for training the network we have created. So supply it with the network, the inputs and the target we require. So this will train the network and after that you can view the network. Test, in this line I have created the test data of 5 dataset. So I will be providing this to the function I have created as well as the network I have created. So I first provided the network and obtained the output, and similarly I create x1, x2, x3 and provided with the function and obtained the target. So I have obtained target and output, then I compare these two for calculating the percentage error to check the accuracy of the network. NMSE is the normalized mean square error with the formula this. So it is mostly preferred for checking the accuracy of this data fitting network, and if it has a value of less than 0.1 then the network is considered good. Then I plotted the regression plot and the plot between the target and output. So if these two coincide, this means the accuracy of the network is good. In this example, I have provided the test data by just randomly creating any numbers, but in real life, we won't be providing any random junk data to the input. So what you might do in that case is use test data that the MATLAB has created by using this command. So this is the command tr.testindices, get the indices of the test data from the input x array that we have created. Then we get those test indices and get the values of those test inputs. And then instead of supplying this test array I have created, you can use this test division data for the same things, percentage error, NMSE that I have done. I have already ran this code and obtained the output, but still let's run this code again. Click on run. The same windows as in the previous video open up and the training is taking place. This shows the view command that I have used to view the network that I have created. One hidden layer with 10 neurons, 3 inputs and 1 output. This is the regression plot. And this is the graph that I have obtained for checking the accuracy. You can create this whole network you have created in the function by using function and the name of the network function you like to create. Now these three shows that if you provide x1, x2 and x3 with these inputs instead of the random integers and obtain the results of percentage error and the NMSE, what you will see is that the results are very poor. So what this means that if we supply the inputs in a particular sequence without any randomness in them, so the accuracy decreases. So it means that the training of the neural network depends highly on the input data that we are providing and the amount of input data, the number of samples we have, as well as the accuracy of that data without the noise and all. You might sometimes require to use more input data processing. So you can use MapSTD or ZScore. So what you do with MapSTD, provide the processing settings, and then after you are trained the network, you just reverse this the output you have obtained using the processing settings you obtained earlier. So you can search for the MapSTD and the ZScore function in the MATLAB documentation. So the commands that I have used here can be seen from by typing net. So net is in the network that we have created. So this shows the various options that we have. Name is the name of the network we have created. User data, we can provide you custom info, number of inputs, number of layers, number of outputs, delays, layer delay, feedback delay, input delay, but there are no delays in the data fitting network, gate element, sample time. Bias connect means the MATLAB uses the convention that the input layer is not considered as the first layer. So the first layer starts from the first hidden layer, and if there is second hidden layer, that will be second layer, and the last layer will be the output layer. So in this case, I have the one hidden layer as first and the output layer as second. So bias connect means that the first hidden layer has a bias connected to it, and the second layer, that is the output layer, has a bias connected to it. Input connect means that the first hidden layer is receiving the input from the input layer, but the output layer not receiving the weight connection from the input layer. So it is zero. Zero means false. Layer connect means that the first hidden layer is not connected with the weight connection to itself, nor it is receiving the weight connection from the output. So actually it is giving the weight connection to the output. That's why it is one for the output layer here, and the output is not receiving any connection from itself. And output connect means the layer that is giving the output. So hidden layer not giving the output, but the output layer is giving the output, so that's why it is one. Inputs, layers, and these are just the arrays for that contains the information. And these are the various functions. These are the functions that I've used in my code. Like I've used this divide function. So I write net.divide function to divide random. You can use divide indices, you can use divide block, and etc. Similarly for divide parameter and the ratios, performance function, and others. You can click on each of it to show the MATLAB documentation for it. For checking the sensitivity of the network, like which input influence the output more, like using the weight connection method or anything, you may require the input weight or the layer weight values or the bias values. So you can use this command for obtaining those. And these are the various methods. Adapt is used for changing the value of weight and biases. Configure for configuring the network with the number of inputs and outputs available. Gensim is for generating the Simulink model. For initializing the weights, performance is the mean square error. Simulink is the simulate. So it do the same thing as this command do. Train I have already used, you have already used. And after you have configured, you can unconfigure the network also. By calling the train, the network is configured automatically. Also type in TR, and these are the various parameters that you obtain. Train function and whatnot. This is I've used TR.test indices. These are the indices, and you supply it to the X vector and to obtain the value of test inputs. And from that you calculate the percentage error. So let's look how to create the Simulink model. Type Gensim network. So this is the network Simulink model. We supply with the constant inputs, and the output is obtained in the scope window. So this is the function fitting neural network. Click mask. You supply the input, the network are processed with the help of map min max function, and this is the formula for that. After that you go to the layer. You have delays, but in this function fitting you don't have any delays. And this goes to the weight. These are the weight data calculated after training of the network. And this goes for the dot product. So whatever input we obtain, we multiply it with weights, and these are combined together, and then finally bias is added to it. And this is the sigmoid function, the sigmoid activation function. This is the formula for it. And then you obtain the output, which goes to the second layer, and the same thing happens here. So after that, deprocessing of inputs or deprocessing of the output obtained takes place, and the output is viewed in the scope window. So that's it, everyone. This is how we train the data fitting neural network in the MATLAB, and this is how we write the script for it. And if you like it, please like, subscribe and share, and stay tuned for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.